One of the very fine collections we have here in the exhibitions is some mummies which were found in the vicinity of Uummannaq, up in the north of Disko Bay, around 70 degrees north. They were found in 1972 by two brothers from Uummannaq. In the graves, there were found six bodies of grown-up women and two children. And the youngest of the children is about 6 months old, and he is presumably a boy. There has been some rumors about the death of this boy, actually, because in some of the stories from the Thule culture, it is told that smaller children could actually be buried with their mothers, even though the baby was alive. To understand the practical reason for that, and that would be that no one in the family or in the household would be able to take care of this little boy. So it is a possibility, but we can't really say if that happened in this case. Well, to understand death in the Thule culture, we also have to have a look at the mythology of Inuit people. And to understand the afterlife, there's a world after this world, and the connection between those is that when people die, they will have to crawl under a huge carpet. And it will take you exactly 1 year to do that journey under the carpet. And in that period, the people you left behind, they will have to pay respect to certain taboos. For instance, they are not allowed to cry too much, because actually what you were doing on that journey under the carpet would be that all the moist, all the water from your body would have to leave your body. You would actually dry out. And all the tears from the crying people would make it difficult for you to crawl under the carpet. So those taboos were made in order to arrange the perfect journey actually under the carpet for the man or woman in order to come to the next world. The women have been experts in the preparations of skin and also the sewing. On the other hand, we also see that the men, they need to be experts in the daily catch. They were able every day to go out and catch something. Of course, there were also periods of starvation, but the techniques and the material, the tools they had, made them able to go out even in the darkest winter night and catch seals through holes in the ice. So it is what they tell us would be that women and men depended certainly on each other, and they were each experts on their own field. If you take a closer look at the faces of the women, you will be able to see the tattoos that they were in their faces. At that time, the tattoos were made with a needle and a studded thread, and then you would just sew just underneath the skin to let the sud make some black color just underneath your skin. And in that way, you could make the tattoo. So if you have a very good look at the faces of the mummies, you will be able to see the tattoos. If you'd like to know more about the mummies, of course you'll have to visit the museum here in Nuuk. Apart from that, it will be possible to do tours in Uummannaq. It will be a question of how many guests shows up in Uummannaq, but a boat ride to Qilagiitsoq can be arranged up there, and then you will be able to see where these people have lived. You can see some ruins from where they have lived, and then the place where the actual grave was found.